Leap to Excel Consulting. Sir is having a vast experience of 17 years in esteemed organizations like Shriram Piston and Rings Limited, Omax Autos Limited, SKF Bearing India Limited, and Lohia Group. Sir conducted 500 plus trainings on problem solving, quality system tools as IATF, TQM, 7QC tools, 5 core tools, TPM, 5S, Kaizen methodology, 6 Sigma, quality circle, team building, etc. Sir is one of the few certified TPM facilitator from CII TPM Club of India, certified 6 Sigma Green Belt, Black Belt, and Business Excellence Facilitator. Sir, we are really fortunate to have you with us and learn from your vast experience and knowledge.
So in Lean concept, we identify 8 type of wastage. Generally, in industry, in manufacturing or in service industry, there are 8 type of wastage. So it is not easy to remember all the names. So some abbreviation is identified downtime. Downtime basically when a machine is running and then it automatically stopped for some breakdown. So we call it breakdown, and the time duration we call it downtime. So downtime is very common term in manufacturing industry. So we use downtime as a identify the waste. So D for defect, defect or wastage. Overproduction, suppose someone has given planning for 1000 pieces, but you have created 1200 pieces, that is not good, that is bad as per lean. Waiting for anything, that is wastage. Non-engaging employees, so suppose we have engineers and engineers is waiting for something, he don't know what to do, means you have not engaged, that is also wastage. Transportation, material is kept in one store and then you need to transport it from one store to manufacturing sector or from one location, that is wastage. Inventory, you are keeping lots of inventory, that is also wastage. Motion, generally we identify motion in assembly section. So what, when you assemble some parts, they check what type of movement you are doing, how much motion you have, leg motion, hand motion, your body motion, so it should be minimized, that is also wastage. And extra processing, so you do processing of one part, but due to some issue you again reprocess it, or you are making it with a superior quality. So ek level se jyada achha bhi banana, it is also a waste in the lean. So lean says you need to identify these type of wastage, 8 type of wastage, and you need to eliminate this. So what is waste? Waste is not a problem, it is a symptom. So we need to find and address cause of waste, why it is happening. So suppose there is a waiting is a wastage as per lean. So you can't directly eliminate, oh don't wait here, so he will wait somewhere. Okay, you need to identify why he is waiting, what is the root cause of that waiting. You need to go to that deep, and after identifying that wastage cause, you can identify, okay, we need to eliminate this activity, then this waste will be eliminated. Okay, so in lean manufacturing there are multiple tools which you need to implement as and when required. Okay, there are more than 20-30 lean tools. So I will be telling you these 5 tools, basics of these 5 tools, because we can't cover, as I said. So first lean tool we are going to cover is a workplace organization. Second, we will be talking about the visual control and management. Third is the batch reduction or elimination. Fourth one is the Pokaioke, and fifth one is SMED. Now the fourth concept is Pokaioke. So Pokaioke, basically it is again a Japanese concept. All the lean tools are Japanese based. Okay. So Pokaioke, it means, Pokaioke says it is a mistake proofing. So generally we do multiple mistakes. In manufacturing, we do lots of mistakes. We do huge mistakes. To avoid that mistakes, Pokaioke concept is created. So in Seizo Singo, who was the Japanese quality engineer, in 1980s he identified this concept to eliminate the error in manufacturing due to mistake of man. How to do? Because generally what happened? Generally we human do multiple mistakes due to forgetfulness, due to misunderstanding, wrong identification, lack of experience, sometimes willful, inadvertence or sloppiness, slowness, lack of standardization, surprise or intentional also. So these type of human mistakes are there, and due to this there are multiple type of losses. Okay, so generally the POCOEC concept says the use of process or design feature to prevent error or their negative impact is called POCOEC. It is inexpensive, very effective and based on simplicity. So there are three type of POCOEC. You can prevent the error, you can detect the error, or you can mitigate the error, means the impact you can reduce. So three type of POCOEC you can do. Now I will show you one this clip, and then you will easily understand what is the POCOEC concept. So one industry, he was making the soap and their customer was complaining, we are getting the wrapper without soap inside. Okay, so they said how to eliminate this. So they can do multiple things. They can put some manpower who is inspecting them. They can do some camera or some sensors to keep that thing. You can use the weighing scale to measure each part, but that all is very costly. So what that industry has done, they have done this, implemented this POCOEC, and what they have done, so in one conveyor they installed one fan and they started that fan continuously. So when there is a soap which is a wrapper which is kept with the soap, if it goes in front of that fan, that goes forward. Why? The back, because that is heavy. And when the wrapper which is without soap, it goes to in front of that fan, that is eliminated with the help of that pressure of the air. That simple thing, you can eliminate a multiple problem. You can avoid the customer complaint, you can avoid the defect. Even you don't need to put any another manpower, you don't need to put any big costly camera or big costly sensors or the weighing scales. This is very simple POCOEC. Okay, so this is called POCOEC, which is a basic design change or something you have changed which is avoided human error. Why this was happened? Because of human error. Some person was packing the soap, but they have done this packing without soap. Or if it is happening automatically, there may be some errors. So we have put this POCOEC. So this type of POCOEC you can see everywhere. Now in this stove, you can see there is a problem. You don't know which dial turns on which burner. So what you will do? We have changed the design of the dial and burner. So in front of each and every dial, the burners are there. So you can easily identify which dial turns which burner. This is also an example.
Thank you, sir. That was an amazingly enlightening talk. I'm sure all of us have learned immensely from it and entered a wider horizon of thought process as students and engineers.